Hi students, welcome to Plus 2 Computer class. Actually, we are discussing about computing. ICT computing, that means advances in computing. We just started the different computing technologies, especially with distributed computing. You know the importance of internet in today's life. So according to that, we are discussing the points in this chapters. Okay. So, in the previous video, we discussed about advances in computing. We just started our 11th chapter, advances in computing. And also, we discussed about the distributed computing paradigm, different approaches in distributed computing paradigm. So, the first one was distributed computing and after that, parallel processing. Then also, we discussed the difference between the parallel processing and serial processing. So, already we discussed the two computing technologies, distributed and parallel. In both, we are dividing problems into small subproblems and distributing that subproblems into different users. Then, in this video, we are going to discuss three more computing concepts. The first one was grid computing. Grid computing, what does mean by a grid and what does mean by grid computing, and after that we will discuss the advantages and disadvantages of grid computing. Then the third one was cluster computing. Cluster computing means knowledge cluster, then resource cluster, so many clusters present. Then cloud computing. Actually, this is one of the most advanced computing. Multinational companies are using cloud computing. Then after that, cloud service model. Different types of cloud service models were present. That all service models we will discuss. So we'll start with our first computing, that is grid computing. Grid computing. Actually, grid computing means the all the resources like computer, desktop, laptop, memory devices, all are connected to form a grid. All, that means all the resources that we require is formed, that means are formed centrally, and it is also known as a grid. In grid computer, we can access computational power or computational resources through as a, that means now we are using electricity. When you on the switch, then automatically electricity will pass. Same concept, the computational power will serve or will supply as electricity. That is explained in grid computing. Okay, all the resources required for a particular application is connected and it forms a grid. Imagine that several million computers like laptop, desktop, all are interconnected, owned by thousands of different peoples, are connected together to form a single huge powerful computer. All the resources all over the world, that means all the devices like computers, desktop, laptops, all are, that means among different peoples, not same peoples, different peoples, they are using their computer their own purposes. Okay, all these resources are formed and it form a powerful computer. This is known as grid computing. Actually, grid computing is described as a world in which the computational power, especially the computational power means the resources and services. Resources means memory, processor, then database management system, and next one is services and data. Services means all the online services like Gmail, then search engines, all the services along with the data. Okay, that is known as computational power. Computational power consists of services, data, and also the resources. Resources definitely from data warehouse or DBMS for accessing data, and services means Gmail service. Actually, Gmail is a special service that we are using for sending and receiving email, and also the amount of data. Then we can use search engines for searching information. So these all are belonging to computational resources. Then power is readily available like electric power. So using switches and socket, we can access internet. You don't want to use any special devices. Okay, in some of the countries, this concept is already implemented. Along with electricity, some of the countries are providing computational power. Okay, Then here user can access computational power just like electricity wall sockets with no care or consideration for work how the electricity is actually generated. Computers on a grid have a program on them that allow the unused resources to be used by another computer on a grid. That means when we use switches or sockets we are getting the computational power. We don't know from where we are getting this kinds of computational power. Like electricity, when you on the switch, we are getting electricity. Then through socket also we are getting. But we don't know how it is generating. The same concept is using in grid computing. Some of the countries are already implemented, but in India it is not implemented. Actually, it is a concept. So we can create a grid. That means it consists of all the several millions of computers from all over the world are connected to form a grid. Then there are different types of grids we can make. Knowledge grid, database grid. That means all the databases from all over the world we can connect as a single grid. Then all the knowledge, that means the information or data coming from different places, that also we can make it as a data grid. So different types of grids we can make, and also we can work on different types of grid. Then grid computing is used in, okay, but which are the places we are using grid computing? Disaster management, weather forecasting. You know, weather forecasting, you want to get the weather from different places. So all these places informations are interconnected. As an overall procedure, we can find out the particular, that means we can find out the weather conditions on a particular day. Then weather forecasting, disaster management, then market forecasting, bioinformatics, etc. Okay, in all these places we are using grid computing. Weather forecasting, disaster management, then data supply, market forecasting, and also bioinformatics. So these are the different fields where we are using grid computing. Grid computing means the computational power is served like electricity or electric power. Then we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of grid computing. The first advantage of grid computing is grid can work safely. For example, if you want to solve complex problem, we can easily use grid computing. Grid computing are capable to solve large and complex problems. Second one, grid computing makes best use of existing hardware. You don't want to share other hardware features. It will use existing hardware and it will work in an effective or efficient manner. The third disadvantage is scalability. Scalability, I already mentioned, we can increase the size and also we can decrease the size. We can add more number of nodes. More number of nodes or more number of computers. Then, disadvantages of grid computing. The first disadvantage is the interconnection of computers, because so many processors are connecting. So the data processing between interconnected computers, the data transmission rate is very slow because so many computers are interconnected. Then licensing issues across the servers or computer. Licensing issue means when we are sharing other places resources, then licensing issues also will come. So actually, when we are using grid computing, the speed of connection between the computers on the grid are relatively slow. That is the main point in grid computing. That means the speed between, or the speed of data sharing between two computers are relatively slow. Clear? So these are the different applications of grid computing. Okay. So hope you understood what is mean by grid computing and what are the advantages and also disadvantages of grid computing. Actually, grid computing is used in disaster management, weather forecasting, and also cybernetics in that fields. Okay. Then, so this was our third computing aspect, grid computing. Then, next one is cluster computing. Next. Cluster computing. Actually, cluster computing also one of the famous computing, especially that we are using in offices and all. In cluster computing, a group of computers, Okay. For example, suppose in multinational companies we are dealing with a particular topic, a group of that particular programmers or group of computing, which personal computer, then storage devices, all that particular devices are interconnected and they work as a single unit and it work as a cluster. Okay, that is known as cluster computing. Actually, cluster computing is a form of computing in which group of personal computer, their processor, memory are linked together to work as a single unit. All these parts are work or linked to work as a single unit. Then, for establishing this, it require fast local area network or LAN connection is must for connecting all these devices together. Then cluster provide computational power through parallel processing. Same time one or more we can execute. All are having different processor but sharing same memory. Then it is relatively low cost from parallel processing machine used for scientific and other application. So the basic concept of cluster computing is parallel processing. You know what is mean by parallel processing. In parallel processing, different processors are working concurrently or parallelly. It can share the memory also. Then actually the speciality of cluster computing is computational power is always available. Okay, the main duty of cluster computing is that the computational power is always available. Then it also uses parallel computing. All the computers are linked together to work as a single unit. This is the speciality of cluster computing. And next we will discuss the advantages. Then, you know, different types of operating system we are using. The commonly used operating systems are Windows and Linux. Linux is belonging to open source software category. Okay, what is it? Open source software category. Then the commonly used operating system for cluster computing is Linux. Okay, the commonly used operating system in Linux. This is very, very important. Linux is most widely used operating system for cluster computing because Linux maintain their own cluster. That means all the softwares and all the programmers that working on Linux can link together to form a single or to work as a single unit. You know, it's an open source software means every time its kernel is changing. So some group of peoples are already ready, always ready to change the structure of Linux. Okay, and it work as a single unit. Clear? Then there are some advantages and disadvantages of cluster computing is present. The first advantage is price performance ratio because we are using Linux operating system and it is open source software. So that's why price performance is very less. Cluster computing significantly reduces the cost of computing power. Then availability. If one node fail, then it will work. It will not affect the entire computer network or it will not affect the entire system. The remaining system will work with reduced system performance. Then scalability. We can increase the number of nodes and also we can decrease the number of nodes. Then the disadvantages are programming complexities. Okay, if we are establishing a different or if we are connecting different resources together as a single unit, definitely there will be programming issues. Okay, then fault tolerance. We can't easily find out the fault or the error on a particular technical error or software error. The error correction and also the identification of error is very risky job comparing to other computing. So these are the two disadvantages: programmability issues and second one, problem in finding the fault. Problem in finding the fault. So these are the different advantages and disadvantages of cluster computing. And last one more computing is present, that is known as cloud computing. Cloud computing. Actually, cloud computing is used in different uses. For example, The commonly used cloud computing example is email or Gmail. You know, in all the users, I think in from children's onwards, all are having their own email ID. Email ID means in every location or in all the overall, that means all over the world, users or the programmers are using Gmail account. So in all the places, Gmail is providing their own server. Server means it is controlled, the entire working of Gmail is controlled by a central server. But in all the physical location, the different types of servers are present. All these servers are communicating each other because it is very large and also complex application. In million or in seconds, millions of requests are coming to Gmail. So for handling all these requests, all in all the different places, Gmail is providing or Gmail is placing different types of servers. Then actually cloud computing is internet. Actually it is based on internet. Cloud computing is an emerging computing technology that uses the internet and central remote servers to maintain data and application. That means Gmail is providing different remote servers in different places. Then using remote server, it will control data and information. Gmail service is an example of cloud computing. Then all the resources required for Gmail is providing and it form as a Gmail cloud. The same picture is present in your textbook, how the Gmail cloud is establishing cloud computing. The all the hardware parts required for the Gmail will be available and it form as a cloud. Then our web-based email service providers like Yahoo, Gmail, Outlook take care of storing all the hardware and software necessary to support our personal email account. You know, the activity present in Gmail is same. Whatever or whoever is using, it is same. So the essential resources for the Gmail is connected and it form as a cloud format. Then in cloud formatting, they are using different types of services model. So the first service model is software as service. In software as service means the customer has least control over the particular service. Okay, the customer has the least service. Example is Google Docs. Okay, you already know, I think some of them is know about Google Docs. Google Docs is free to all the Gmail users. Okay, actually it's a free service for all the Gmail user. So whoever is using the Gmail, they are getting Google Docs feature as free. Then actually it is Docs, that means we can save documents on this particular software, but we don't have a control over that particular software. That's why the least control, that means the customer has the least control over the service. That is the first service, software as service. Subscribers access to both resources and application. Example, if you are using Gmail, we can access Google Docs for sharing your data. Then here a complete application is offered to the customer as a service on demand. The customer purchases the ability to access and use an application or service that is hosted in the cloud. Actually it is hosted in Gmail cloud, so we can make use of Google Docs. If you are the customer of Gmail, then easily we can use Google Docs. Actually it is a software provided by that particular software or particular service. Then so I already mentioned the main point is INSA, software as service. It will termed as SaaS, software as service, SaaS model. Then in agreement, customer has the least control over the software. Then the second service is platform as service. Platform as service, PaaS, PaaS. Okay, PaaS, that means platform as service. You know, in different cloud model, they are using different platforms. Platforms means operating system. I already mentioned in cluster computing, the most widely used operating system was Linux. So it may be, there may be chance of Linux and also Windows operating system present, and also Mac OS also will be present. So this service model is based on the platform. You know, for creating some of the software, we can use WAMP and also LAMP. Okay, WAMP and also LAMP. WAMP means Windows, Apache, MySQL, PHP. So it is based on Windows operating system. Then LAMP based on Linux operating system. So the platforms are different. So according to the platform, the service will be provided. If it is belonging to Windows, then according to the Windows operating system or Windows platform, cloud is providing the services. If it is Linux, then according to the operating system, cloud is providing the services. That is belonging to platform as service. And one more is, sir, that is infrastructure as service. Infrastructure as service. That means IaaS. Capital IaaS. Infrastructure as service. In infrastructure as services, it is based on the infrastructure, especially relating to the name of the state. Okay, in which state, then which kind of network technology we are using, wired or wireless, storage devices, memory devices, database that we are using, all the infrastructure will check according to that the services providing. That is the another aspect that we are using in cloud computing. Infrastructure. Here, the name of the state deals primarily with the computational infrastructure, as provide basic storage of computing capabilities as standardized services over the network, server, storage system, networking equipment, data centers, spaces, etc. So whichever infrastructure that we are using, it will work according to that particular infrastructure. Then, so these are the specialty of cloud computing. Then the different service models are, the first one was service as a software as service, that is SaaS, software as service. Then platform as service, PaaS. Then infrastructure as service, IaaS. So these are the services used by cloud computing for performing. Then we will discuss the advantages and disadvantages of cloud computing. The first advantage is cost saving. Cost saving means all these are connected together, then definitely it will reduce the computational cost. The second one was scalability or flexibility. Scalability means we can increase the number of node and also we can decrease the number of node according to the user, or if the number of users is increasing, we can increase the number of nodes. The third one is reliability. Reliability means if any one section is not working, it will not affect the entire network, it will work. The third one is maintenance. Cloud service providers do the system maintenance, thus reducing maintenance requirement. So all these are interconnected and formed as a cloud, so maintenance is easy. Then the disadvantages is lack of security. That is the first disadvantage, is lack of standard. Lack of standard means cloud has no standards. Okay, cloud has no standard. Some of the companies creating their own clouds for their own purpose. Okay, according to their personal use, they are creating clouds. So that's why they has no standard, and thus it is unlikely the most clouds are interoperable. Okay, unlikely the most clouds are interoperable. Then next one, security and privacy. Security and privacy means we can communicate with each other. That means one cloud can communicate with other. Then in communication, there is no security. So if we are passing messages, that message can be stealed by any of the hackers, and also they can hack your personal informations. So that is security level, lack of security, security and privacy. So these are the two disadvantages, lack of standard and security and privacy. These are the two disadvantages of cloud computing. So cloud, the most commonly used example is Gmail. Gmail is providing cloud computing, their own cloud for managing their data transfer. Okay, so hope you understood the three computing methods that we are using in advances in computing. So again, we will revise the topics that we study. The first topic was grid computing. So we know what is mean by a grid, how we are creating a grid. Grid computing is described as a world in which computational power is readily available, like electric power. Then second one, advantages and disadvantages of grid computing. After that, we discussed about cluster computing. Actually, cluster computing is a form of computing in which a group of personal computer like storage devices, etc. are linked together so they can work like a single unit. Then after that, cloud computing. Cloud computing is emerging computing technology that uses the internet and central remote services to maintain data and application. Then after that, we discussed about the different cloud service model. The first model was SaaS, software as service. Second model was platform as service. Third model, infrastructure as service. Which infrastructure or which method we are using, according to that it will work. Okay, so you can expect one essay question from this. What are the different various computing methods? Then you want to write some question in your notebook. The first one was list the advantages of cluster computing, especially advantages. Then after that, list the advantages and limitations of cloud computing. Both advantages and disadvantages you want to write. Okay, so please read your text thoroughly, especially this is theory section. So please read your text thoroughly and identify the valid reasons. Then the remaining sections of this chapter, that means artificial intelligence and computational intelligence, we will discuss in the next video. Okay, then thank you.